This is Bodyguard and Big Phil Radio Show. And as you can hear, me and Big Phil might attend the All-Gill. So, we're not going to do no talk or radio shows or whatever. We could, I mean, depends who it is, as long as it's not one of Big Phil's haters. We're going to talk about politics, news, and other stuff. We'll see. The town hall meetings have people out there arguing. And, protesters. Protesters and all that. And, let's see, with the senators and all that, I don't think they're really listening. They say they are listening, and they won't really listen. I mean, you can tell by people that listen. I mean, I can actually tell when someone's listening. I mean, I highly doubt they actually was listening. I mean, the only senator I could probably tell by was listening was Chuck Grassley. I know people can disagree on that, but I said Chuck Grassley was the only listener so far, as I can tell. And someone put a Nazi sign on, David Scott's, office? I mean, right there, that was completely wrong. I mean, that was just completely wrong. The guy did not deserve having a sign like that on his office. I mean, even though David Scott can be, I don't know, but I just well say, why put a sign on his office as a nonsense sign? I mean, that is completely wrong. I mean, what is with these people out there? I mean, there's even posters out there putting Obama out there with Joker. I mean, I don't think that's why right there. I mean, that is not good. I mean, he would say, well, it's against all this policy and all that. Well, something else. And, well, it's all confused people. Whatever's going on in this world is pretty much a bunch of nutcases. I mean, there's both sides fighting for each other. One saying, oh, yeah, we're all going to die. And other says, oh, we're all going to be fine. I mean, what's the truth about this, people? Who the hell is hiding something? I don't know who, if it's coming from the White House, I don't even know if it's coming to Alex Jones, I don't know, but where's the proof in this? I am getting sick and tired hearing this every single day. And forced vaccine in some states. What is inside the vaccine? How is it going to affect people? Wake up. Come on, we're not going to be sick and tired hearing about this all the time, and I'm definitely not liking how I'm hearing that vaccines could actually cause diseases when it's happening in a few countries out there. And if you said you got a problem talking about that, then you know what, help me go research about vaccine and get your butt out there now. Sorry for my language, but you know what, I'm getting sick and tired. People out there are just really pissing me off.
Yeah, I know about that. I mean, Wayne Knighty was speaking about, how he couldn't do things right. I mean, I don't know what's with him.
We're not talking about 19 here, Phil. We're talking about politics, news, and vaccine, and all that, force and all that stuff. I mean, this ain't work that comes in martial law. And then we got military in our neighborhood, jamming out our doors and dragging people out. I don't know if that's really gonna happen. I mean, I'm hoping not. I mean, we got our freedom, people. Come on. We got our freedom. We need our freedom. We don't want that to let that die. We don't need to be no one's slave around here. I mean, I'm not saying I'm agreeing with Alex Jones. I'm not saying I'm agreeing with the White House. I'm trying to stay neutral in this level at the moment. And, I mean, come on. We need to think here. We're humans. We got brains. We're not demons here.
Do we say demons?
Yes, I said we said demons, Phil. Because the reason why I said that is, why are we acting like kids when we need to act like grown-ups and think of things out? I mean, if I was a senator, I would have been at least listening to town hall people, not ignoring them. I'm not saying not all the senators don't do that. I mean, I've seen Chuck Grassley out there talking to people and all that, and it seemed like he read the bill. I mean, come on, read a bill. If it's even 20,000 pages, I mean, come on. I mean, there's probably some parts of that bill is probably bad. I don't know. I mean, what's with these people these days? I mean, they can't even read a single bill? Oh. Well, then why is that bill even written? Who made the bill? I mean, the bill's not even been made. How would it destroy? I don't know. I'm not saying... What am I saying again?
You said destroy the bill.
Did I say that?
Yeah, you said that.
Oh, crap. Well, No, excuse me on that. People should have a right on things in their life. I mean, they can't have their privacy go away like other countries are starting to have that happen. I mean, people are starting to freak out thinking there's going to be a civil war out there. I mean, come on, people. If you want to keep your peace around here, keep your peace. We cannot let things destroy us in a way. I mean, this is America. Come on. This is freedom. Come on. Think of it. And if you're trying to bring God into this, let me tell you this. God wouldn't like the fact of people being forced to vaccine. God wouldn't like the fact of that. God would also not like the fact of, let's see what else. People out there arguing with each other. God probably will have people listen to each other. I mean, I know there's a lot out there that's not Christians and all that. But I would say I would know what God would think of. Trust me, I know people that go to pretty much spiritual ministries and all that. And they're very, very close to God, and God would actually speak to them. Well, more like when you... It's difficult to explain if you can hear from Slayer's eye point idea. I mean, we might have him as a special guest. Yeah, but you know Slayer's going to be super pissed when he's about to force the vaccine in Florida because he's moving now. All I know, he's going to be super pissed. Okay, now, as I would say, people, I mean, don't get too much worried about the simple future. We don't even know what's really going to go on. I mean, maybe it's just going to be end up, we're going to be living the next year. And then they're saying now FEMA camps. I mean, what's that going to be for? People who do not choose vaccine? Oh, people are going to cause trouble when they're actually doing nothing? I mean, come on, you got to really think what's the real crime here. The real crime here is people killing people. That's the real crime. What's not a crime, it's just people just standing up for their rights and freedom. That's just not a crime, that's their freedom. God would expect something like that, but God wouldn't expect someone trying to make people as slaves. No, that's not what God wants here. I mean, I'm not trying to be like a preacher or apostle or a prophet here. I'm just saying as opinion. I'm just saying that, even though people want to ignore me, but this is Bodyguard. Come on, you're listening to a guy who knows experience of things in life. You know experience of things being monster. You too. But let's not get to that idea. We want to get here to explain things that people, if you're worried about something, just pray about it, alright? Just pray about it. Don't just ignore what's the bad stuff out there, because you don't know if there's going to be a bad thing out there, or maybe not, I don't know. I mean, if I'm confusing you of me speaking, sorry, I'm just speaking too fast because, I don't know, I'm just... These things going on here, I don't know why. I just don't know why what's going on with these people out there thinking, oh look, I'm gonna woo all these people. Oh look, I'm gonna tell these people about this stuff to freak them out. Oh, come on. No. I mean, we live in a state that's pretty much peaceful around here. I would hate to see this state I live in blown out, angry mob, or people with uniforms shooting us. I don't expect to see that. No. No, come on. We need our freedom. People need to live their lives. To have the jobs they want. To support their kids. I mean, I highly doubt the swine flu ain't that bad. Some say it is. Well, I might disagree on that one. But that's all I'm going to say on today's radio. And hope this... that everything will go okay in the next week or so. Probably not. But we'll see what goes on. I mean, if things stay calm. Guys, just pray about it, alright? Just pray. And God bless you all. And we all know we love America. And we know we don't hate other countries, okay, people? Don't get to that idea. We are friendly people. Well, some of us can be. Well, probably half of us. I don't know. But we all friendly people. Everyone just to say out there that we love you all. God bless you all. This is Bodyguard and Big Phil's radio show. Nice talking to you all.